Hello everyone and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. So in today's episode we're gonna have a short video because I'm packing right now to start our trip to Italy. So after this video we're gonna start to drive down to Italy. So in tomorrow's video I will be already in the first city. We don't know yet if it's gonna be Florence or Rome, so make sure to tune in also for tomorrow's video with the live stream from Italy. Alright, so Bitcoin after yesterday's little drop here immediately corrected back up here towards the close of the CMEs. So currently we are back into the level where the CMEs closed at around 9,275. So I guess that till tomorrow not much is gonna happen and most likely we will not create a new CME gap, but of course we still need to wait and see what will happen once we're coming into the end of this little consolidation wedge here that could easily break out here to the upside or to the downside. So the thing is that currently we're still having this green line as a resistance, which is currently at around $9,400. And I think as long as we're not able to break through and create a support above $9,400, so above this coming down resistance here from this falling wedge, I think there is a very high chance that we could see maybe this week or next week a potential bigger dump towards our bearish targets. So you have to be prepared for both scenarios, my friends. If you're all in still and you didn't take any profits out, think about maybe to take a little bit of profits out, because I still think if we're not able in the next couple of days to break through $9,400 and create a support above, we could see a major dump also in the traditional markets. And here in Bitcoin my targets would be towards the 200 daily moving average, even down towards to $7,200 to $6,400. I will show you why those targets later on in the weekly time frame. But here in the 1 hour it looks like that we're building up here some support above the 20 moving average, so above $9,250. We have the RSI back above the 50. Stochastic is coming in overbought condition, so here I think we're just gonna jump here between 9,230 and here this $9,300 resistance. So most likely we're gonna jump around this area here before we're gonna see here a breakout to the upside towards $9,400, or also a breakdown here towards the target of this little wedge, which would be at around $9,120 and also would create a higher low. And if we have a look on the Bollinger Band here, also after overshooting it to the upside, we retrace back down here to the first middle line. So in theory, now we could trade here between 9,260 and 9,240 here in the 1 hour. MACD's also shifted to the upside, didn't have a bearish cross yet. So here we still have some room left to the upside, and in theory, we could go up again to retest $9,300. We have to see what will happen if we're going towards 9,300 to 9,400. Maybe this could be a good short opportunity, but it's up to you if you want to short it here over on Bybit or Bityard, for example, or maybe wait for a possible dump and then start to scale in long positions like I prefer to do. And now let's go over to the 4 hour time frame, because here also you can see that we're squeezing between these moving averages here in the 4 hours, so between the 50, 20 and the 200, which is giving us a resistance. We have the RSI right at the 50 and stochastic is coming in overbought condition. So here also you can see that $9,300, where the 200 moving average is lining up, could be the new resistance. And if we're not able to start to trade again and build up support above this level and also possibly break from this green line here, which is coming down now since many days, if we zoom out you can see that this line here is very important to be broken in order to have a possible retest here of 10,000 and maybe even go higher towards 11,000, which is also still in the cards. But if we are able to break 10,000, then I think not only 11,000 is possible, maybe even go up to test 12 to 14,000 very soon. But at the moment we are still having some problems here to break through $9,400. It is a bullish pattern all in all, but of course we can also continue to trade within this pattern for many days and also create lower lows on the way. So that is a bit the problem if you start already to scale in longs here before a potential breakout. And now let's go over to the Bollinger Band in the 4 hour, because here also we are trading right here in the middle area, so we should see a big bounce from it pretty soon, and the target would be up here towards $9,400. where also we're gonna see if we are getting rejected there or if we're able to break through. And you see also that the MACD is having a bullish cross here pretty soon, so I think there is a very high chance that we could see here a big push to the upside coming up in the next couple of hours, maybe tomorrow when the markets are starting to trade again. But all in all, at the moment it's really indecisive. We have a lot of resistance above us, but also everything is pointing that we could see this retest of 9400 coming up pretty soon. And now let's open up the daily time frame, because here in the daily you can also see that the 50 daily moving average is here at $9,400. So I think there is a very high chance also here that we could go up here to retest the 50 daily, and also here we have to see if we can close a daily candle above $9,400. The RSI is also right at the 50 level, stochastic in neutral condition. So also here, if today we are able to close above 9,275, so where the CMEs closed on Friday, then I think we could see a retest of $9,400. And it's up to you if you want to take this long, maybe to ride it up towards 9,400 and then see if we are able to break it or not. In case that you took this long and we are getting rejected here, then make sure to close your trade or put a very tight stop loss somewhere at around 9,350. And now let's open up the Bollinger Band in the daily time frame, because also here you can see that we are right now between here the two middle lines, which are around $9,200 to $9,300 as well. And also here the target to the upside would be at around $9,500. And if we crash down, then look out for $8,950. That would be the target, where also I think the support is of this current yellow line here, which Bitcoin is currently supporting. So in case that we're gonna break below 8,950, then watch out for the 200 daily moving average here at $8,500. This is my target in case that 8,950 will not hold in case of a breakdown here from this area which we are currently. And now let's open up the weekly time frame, because here in theory we're still bullish, we're still on our way towards 10k. We are trading above the 20 weekly, above the 50 in the RSI. Stochastic is a bit concerning because it's still in overbought condition, but it's already starting to cool off here a little bit. And here you can also see my bearish targets, because in case of a drop here to the downside, if we're gonna also lose the 20 weekly moving average at $8,700, this is the first area which I'm gonna watch here, where we previously had a lot of support and resistance here after the crash of March. You can see that the price had problems to break through $7,200, where the 0.5 fib line is lining up, and afterwards it acted as a support, and from there we also bounced and had this big run here towards $10,000. So in case of a major dump, I think $7,200 is a level which I definitely gonna start to scale in longs. And this is also potential bottom area in case of another major dump. We could even wick down or have a retest of the 0.618 fib line at 6,400. So these two levels are the levels that I'm watching in case of a breakdown here to the downside, and where I'm gonna start to scale in more longs and also buy some more cheaper bitcoins. Because as I told you, it is possible that this is gonna be the last time that you can buy cheap bitcoins. It's just a matter of time now. Also, the 200 moving average in the weekly is coming up towards the 0.618 at $6,400. So I think it is very likely in case that we're gonna see again a big dump, not maybe here on Bitcoin, but also in the traditional markets, that also Bitcoin is coming down to test this level down here again, and then have a big bounce from it and possibly then break this big resistance that is coming down here, and then start to test here these levels towards $14,000, $16,000, and $20,000 again. Alright guys, and with that said, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. Don't forget to tune in also tomorrow for the subscription video for our $10 worth of Bitcoin giveaway, which we do every week, and it's sponsored by BitYard. So make sure to tune in tomorrow for the subscription video. I will do it probably in the late afternoon, somewhere around there, because I will be in Italy. So we're gonna do that live over on Twitch, and then also the replay here on YouTube. But the important thing is that you're gonna comment and leave your Bitcoin address on tomorrow's video, where it says subscription video here on YouTube. And don't forget, if you want to trade over on Bybit with your Bitcoins, Ethereum, EOS, XRP, with leverage, then make sure to use the link that you find down below here in the video description. For Bybit, you can get up to $90. If you use my sign up link, you also support the channel. And also for BitYard, here you can trade with your Tether, all these coins that you see over here. So if you have some Tether on the sideline and you don't want to use your cryptos to trade with, then BitYard is the exchange for you. And here also you can get up to $260 in boni if you use my sign up link. Alright guys, so thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe here, leave a like, leave any comment you want. It helps the algorithm of YouTube, and also make sure to join our free Discord trading chat. The chat is completely for free, everyone is welcome, and of course also the Twitch link you find down below here where I do the live streams. So thank you very much my friends, and we see us all in Italy the next time. Bye!